How many understand that what I'm saying about Exodus is this? That Exodus is a story of a faithful God visiting a family, your family, my family, our lives, in his faithfulness and manifesting his deliverance, his intervention, his power to rescue and empower his own people. That's what Exodus is all about. You got it? Then we need to understand in the midst of Exodus, as they were being brought out of slavery, all of a sudden at the end of that book, we get the Ten Commandments. So God says, I'm going to rescue you from where you are, but I'm going to empower you to live above sin and other traps that could take you out. And I'm going to give you 10 commandments, not 10 suggestions. And I know Jesus came to fulfill the commandments. You know that on two things hang all the law and prophets, right? Love God with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength, and your neighbor as yourself. But the foundational revelation of the commandments is still available to us today. But God was saying this, hey, I'm bringing you out of bondage, and I want to bring you into your divine purpose, your promised land, but I'm going to give you some rules that if you'll follow these things, you're going to live in freedom. Somebody shout freedom.
Freedom.
Ah, and as Kevin LeVar sang, we're going to live in freedom, and the devil is going to do what? Burn in a lake of fire. I didn't know devil had a boss. That was good. Revelation. We sang about that. And so God says, you're going to stay on the victory side, on the blessing side, by keeping the commandments I give to you. Does that make sense? So the commandments are not limitations. They're ways of empowerment. The commandments aren't some hard thing. The commandment is the train track in which your new life is supposed to carry itself forward on that course to destination blessing. Does that make any sense? You can't make it into your purpose. You can't make it from Baltimore, Penn Station, down to Union Station without some train tracks for Amtrak to ride on. And those are the blessings of God. Turn with me to Exodus chapter 23, verse 20. If I had the time, I'd talk about the seven blessings of the Passover. We're only going to get to a few of them today, but what I want you to do is to understand that it makes a difference if you're expectant, if you're believing God to do something in this Passover season. How many know when Passover began this year? Anybody know offhand? April 14th, the day before tax day. I believe next year it's tax day. Woo, it's the Passover. I wonder whether that'll work on taxes. Passover, Passover. Praise God. On the Passover, remember, we already said it, the blood of lambs were put on the doorposts of the houses, right? And the everywhere where the death angel that God sent went over and saw the blood, there was not the death of the firstborn, right? Everywhere where there was not that blood, there had to be the taking of the life of the firstborn. Wow. And so I believe that there is an expectation that we can have during times of Passover that will allow the Lord to do something in our life. Some of us are facing some circumstances like Israel was facing. We feel like we're stuck in under situations. We're in some form of slavery and trying to come out. So look at Exodus 23:20. I'm going to just list off a couple of things. Every time during Passover, we should, you want to write this down. Number one, know that God sent an angel before them. This might actually appear on the screen. God sent an angel before them. Look at Exodus chapter 20, chapter 23, 20. Said, behold, I am sending an angel before thee to keep thee in the way and to bring thee into the place which I have prepared. Beware of him and obey his voice. Provoke him not, for he will not pardon your transgressions, for my name is in him.